Thank you for that applause, people I invited. So I'll just start by telling you a little about myself. I work in North St. Louis. If you've never been there, it's breathtaking. Literally, people will steal your air from you. I got robbed for 8 Sacagawea coins and a Styx Greatest Hits CD. I can understand the Sacagawea coins because they kind of resemble pirate treasure. But the Styx, come on, man. You know, after I get mugged, I like to cry into my hands and listen to Renegade. Anyways, I was on my lunch break down there one day. I'm eating at the Burger King on National Bridge. And I'm just sitting there, minding my own, eating my tender crisp. And this guy walks up, he goes, "Yo, man, I got that epidemic." I didn't know what to say, so I was just like, "Word?" Because I just thought he was discreetly trying to tell me that he had the AIDS virus. But it turns out he was just trying to sell me heroin. Needless to say, it was a pretty lazy work day. Speaking of being lazy, I watch a lot of TV. I like that show, Cash Cab. I like that show because it teaches me things. But not like answers to useless trivia questions. It teaches me things like the easiest way to make an ass out of yourself on television is to raise the roof. That's actually a pretty good rule for any time you're anywhere ever. I see a lot of commercials now for the 3D TV. And I refuse to buy one of those because I'm fucking broke. But I would like to have a 3D TV. I'd like to watch porn on a 3D TV. 3D porn would probably be pretty realistic. And by realistic, I mean me sitting home alone on a Friday night watching porn. What I was going to say next. Yeah, I'm on a bit of a dry spell right now with the ladies. It's been a while. It's kind of getting to the point where my mom's getting involved. She says that I need to get a girlfriend, and I'm pretty sure I'm on their prayer list at her church. You know you got a shitty sex life whenever even your mom thinks the only way you're going to get laid is through divine intervention.
Thank you.
And I forgot what I was going to say again. Shit.
It's all that weed you smoke.
It is. I used to have a girlfriend. Thank you for that. You got me right on the right track. I used to have a girlfriend. Didn't work out. You know, she said I smoke too much pot, and I'm not goal-oriented enough, which is bullshit, because I have a lot of goals. Most of them stemming from the other day when I scored that hat trick on FIFA 10 World Cup Edition. But, you know, I'd like to meet like an 18-year-old high school dropout, because I don't want to date anybody that's accomplished more than me. And it also won't be weird that I still live with my parents. I can say things like, "You want to come over and check out my room? 10x10 with a twin bed and a Miley Cyrus poster." And that won't be creepy. That'll just be things that we have in common. One thing about these younger girls, though, is they're like the bad boy. Like the more dangerous you are, the more pussy you're ultimately going to get. So I'd like to take that to the next level, and I want to be a bad boy in the same way that, like, Ted Bundy was considered a bad boy. All I'm saying is I already have a large stockpile of 55-gallon drones in my attic. Just saying, it makes sense. But final word of advice, ladies, if you run into me in a dark alley struggling to load a couch into a van, keep walking.